Hello, I'm Bertrand with Bike Tires Direct, and we are here today to talk about the anatomy of a tire. Whether you're new to the sport or a veteran and just want to learn more, this is going to be a nice little intro dive into what makes up a bicycle tire. Come along for the ride. First up, and probably most notably, is the casing, sometimes referred to as carcass of the tire, which comprises the entire structure. It's made up of a woven material like nylon or cotton and is counted in threads per inch, or TPI. If it's a lower TPI, the threads have to be bigger, or if it's a higher TPI, the threads can be a little bit smaller. And in some cases too, there's more rubber that has to go in to fill in the gaps for lower TPI tires. In either case, as a rule of thumb, low TPI tires are heavier, more durable, but not quite as supple and not as good at absorbing ride vibrations, whereas high TPI tires are very supple. You can get some really good ride quality from them. Lighter, but also very fragile. There are some notable exceptions we've found to this though, so don't be so quick to judge a tire by its TPI. Next up is tread, which is arguably the most important part of the tire because it's the main point of contact between your bicycle and the road or the trail. The tread is fused to the casing by either vulcanization or rubberizing, or sometimes it's glued in the case of higher end road and cyclocross tires. Treads can range from either slick to intermediate to then knobby tires, depending on the use case scenario. Both the tread and the casing are rubberized in what's called a compound. A compound is some form of rubber with additional additives, usually a proprietary mix from a brand, that's designed to have certain qualities. They can either be soft and grippy or harder and more durable. The trade-off is that the soft ones will wear more quickly, whereas the durable ones won't give you as good of a ride feel. One additional way that companies can alter the ride feel of a tire is by the thickness of the rubber or the compound on both the sidewalls and the tread. Thicker, softer compounds will offset a little bit of that fast wearing. Thicker, harder compounds will make them even more durable. And then different thicknesses in different other places of the tire can affect both durability, ride feel, really all of that. The one trade-off is that thicker compounds and thicker rubberization means more weight. Next up is the bead. And the bead of the tire is the portion that is right here along the bottom edges. And it's the main point of contact between the tire and the rim. Beads are always rubberized in some respect, and they're made up of either a Kevlar or a steel wire that goes through them. And that's what gives the tire its shape and rigidity. In some cases, there are folding tires, which are made up of more Kevlar type materials like all the tires up here, and they can be, as you can see, folded. And there's also wire bead tires, which are made up of heavier steel beads. And those are ones that aren't easily as folded. They're usually a little less expensive because of that, but also harder to mount. In terms of the bead, it's designed to either interface with the hook of a bicycle rim on hooked rims, and that combined with the air pressure keep the tire in place, or in the case of hookless rims, the bead is designed very specifically to interface with the rim in a way such that the air pressure alone can hold it in place. Next on our list is the sidewall, which is the part of the tire that's not covered by the tread. In the case of all these examples, it'll be the tan portion of the tire, you can easily see. The sidewall can vary greatly in thickness depending on the use application, with downhill mountain bike tires being made of multiple layers, thick as all get out to withstand roots and rocks, anything the trail throws your way, and more road racing tires being so light that you can see the threading beneath them, and they're designed for weight savings and then maximum suppleness. And last but certainly not least on our list is going to be puncture protection, which can be made up of any number of compounds, additives, different materials. Puncture protection can be inserted between the tread and the casing, between different layers of the casing, or really anywhere in the tire that the manufacturer wants to assure that riders will not experience a failure. And there you have it. That concludes our general overview of the anatomy of a bicycle tire. We hope you learned a little bit today. Thanks for joining along, and keep your eye out down the line for some deeper dives into some of the topics we think deserve a little more attention. We'll see you out there.